I'm home. Where can you be more comfortable more than home? I love my town, I love my people, and I love Haiti.
5 years after an earthquake devastated Haiti, Josue Lajeunesse is back home. But this is a homecoming unlike any other. Here in the village where he was born, La Sousse, Haiti, Josue is a hero.
Okay.
You're like a celebrity here.
I really don't like the word, you know, celebrity. I'm a server for them, you know, to save them.
Growing up here, there was no easy access to clean water. Until just a few years ago, villagers had to make this dangerous 3-hour trek up and down this mountain to a fresh spring.
You had to walk up to get the water?
To get the clean water. My parents, you know, I don't want them to drink, you know, the contaminated water.
Those who couldn't climb the mountain drank the water from the river, the same river used for laundry, bathing, and by livestock. Many got sick.
When me and my brother was going up, my brother fell down.
Trying to get water.
I said, Chris Medon, what do you think we can do?
How old were you when you said that?
Probably like 8-10 years old.
So this has been a dream 40 years in the making.
Yeah.
That dream to bring clean water here to this village was finally realized. But only after tragedy struck in 2010.
On the breaking news out of Haiti, the largest, most powerful earthquake in the region's history has crippled the country, measuring 7.0.
Josue lost 11 family members in the earthquake. Living in the U.S., working as a janitor at Princeton University, he felt helpless as he watched the horrific news unfold from 1,500 miles away. At the same time, he was even more determined to help.
Trust me personally, if you don't, I can assure you.
Inspired by his dream, students at Princeton rallied around his cause.
Any help that you give to this cause, you will not.
With the help of generosity.org, they raised $38,000, enough to build a pipeline from the fresh spring on top of the mountain down to the village. It's a story of struggle and triumph. A story of one man uniting his village to overcome all odds.
Bravo, Mounou! Bravo! Bravo!
All captured in a documentary fittingly named La Sousse.
It's like something like a miracle. Something you will never believe can be done. And then all of a sudden, manually, we don't have no pump.
Ça dit que l'eau ça moi senti que l'eau ça vient là comme si que c'est bon Dieu qui descend sous terre.
Nous capable d'y porter un paquet de changement et pour zone parce que normalement l'eau bien gardé et bois ça yo c'est à cause de l'eau qui fait nous arriver planter yo.
Not only do they have the main water source and the faucets, but in some of these houses they actually have running water now. They can shower now, they can wash dishes now, they can cook with water now.
Thousands now rely on this pipeline for clean water. But perhaps what makes this all the more amazing is how Josue lives today, every day, in the U.S., as a single father of four working two jobs.
Good job.
He's a taxi driver by night and a janitor at Princeton by day.
If I can work in another two job again to change, you know, the community and the life of the kids, you know, for the next generation, I will.
To me, Josue's story symbolizes the power of one person that can make a difference. If they work hard, they rally people together. It's an example of how this country can grow and rebuild.
What happens if it starts raining?
Jordan Wagner and his team filmed every step of the way.
We screened this film in hundreds of universities and churches and businesses and rallied the support of thousands of people to get behind this vision of bringing clean water to Haiti. And because of this film, we've raised over $150,000 directly for water projects and have funded 20 more water wells all around Haiti.
But despite all this, Josue feels like he hasn't done enough.
I do not think I work hard enough.
What?
I do not think I work hard enough.
You don't think you work hard enough?
No, I should do more.
You said to me when we got here, I should have done more for them.
But I feel they have a lot of necessity. I don't know what next, you know, I can do.
Josue and his brother Chris Madome want to do more. They want to build a school right here in La Sousse.
Kounya nou kapab di n'a vive avec un grand espoir dans la communauté par rapport avec l'osa qui ensemble avec nous là.
Even though they've repaired a lot since the earthquake 5 years ago, you still see so much that needs to be done here. You still have a population where 80% of the people live below the poverty line. It's overwhelming and daunting to think, how do you help everyone?
For the first time this fall, Josue returned home and showed the film that has already done so much to help to the people he helped the most.
When I see this movie, I feel so good because one Asian like me who had a dream and who made something very, very, very important.
Thank you, brother.
Josue may never think that he has done enough, but he's given his people much more than water.
The government cannot do everything. The Haitian, you know, population need to take the responsibility also. Everybody, you know, can help, can put hands together, all of us, because this is our country.